neighbor drawing, taking a little trip over to the candy shop. Hey there, folks. This is Tad Jessup, and as you know, in less than a month, July 11th to the 13th, it is Pedaling for Parkinson's here in Parry Sound. Been doing my training with Peter Estevan. We're actually going out tonight. I heard something like 30 kilometers we're doing tonight, so I'm a little nervous about that. But I got a chance to talk to his brother over the weekend, Stewart Estevan. He is a longtime volunteer and has ridden this race many times. Here's what he had to say. Okay, so Stewart, how did you get involved with Pedaling for Parkinson's?
Well, Ted, that's a great question. And basically, I was heavily volunteered into this because my brother is one of the co-organizers for the Pedaling for Parkinson's.
Oh, you know what? We can say who it is. Everyone knows him here who's listening to the most.
Yeah, so good old Peter Istvan and his best buddy, Dave Newell. Two of them co-founded that ride 4 years ago now, so this is going to be the fourth year that it's going. And I think that's one of the things, being a family member, you're automatically volunteered to participate.
Well, we talked last week about how crucial volunteering is to this entire event. What kinds of stuff do you do for the Pedaling for Parkinson's?
Well, Peter and his wife, Kathleen, really have it mapped out quite nicely. And I do participate. I ride. Generally speaking, I'm doing a shorter ride because then my brother, Peter and David, have me kind of out and about at some of the rest stations.
Oh, okay.
So basically, anywhere along the route, there are rest stations, and so I'd be helping with that. As you probably already know, Krista and Pam make all these infamous or famous chocolate chip cookies.
Oh, yes. Pam told us all about those.
Through there.
Yes.
Chocolate chip cookie and a hug, like it or not.
Well, hey, if it's you hugging me or Pam hugging me when I need one, as long as I get a hug, it'll be okay. But that's interesting that you're volunteering both and riding at the same time.
Yeah, so you can really do a bit of everything. I think what Peter and Dave really want to try to promote is the fact that it's a ride. It's not a race. It's very low-key grassroots. So you can pick your distances as short or as far as you go. I think the short one I usually do with my son and his girlfriend, and then maybe one of the two other days I'll go a little bit longer, like 75 or 80K. And I leave the big routes for those guys like Barbara, my brother and Dave. They seem to like to ride a lot, and then they count on the volunteers to sort of just make sure that everybody's collected at the end of the day. Nobody's forgotten out on the course. And it's a really nice feel. I think for those people that come up and participate in this ride, they'll see that it's really different than a lot of these other rides that are run throughout the year.
Well, it's less than a month away, and I know we're all really, really looking forward to it. And one thing that we haven't really touched on is you can sign up as part of a team. And I know that Stewart, that's something you do every year.
That's right, Ted. So we sign up individually, and then in my case in particular, my two partners at work, I've dragged them out for the last couple of years, and now our assistant and her husband, they also sign up, and then they're part of our company team, the Watermark Wealth Management team. So my son, his girlfriend, I think we're about 10 people now.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so it really has grown. I think the first year I was just out there with my two partners, and now we're a group of 10. We have a team goal. We have individual goals. But I think Peter and Dave have mentioned that before, that you know, you don't have to have raised a minimum. They like you to raise as much as you can.
Beautiful. Now, is there a strategy when you go along with the team? Like, do you guys all ride together? Do you do it relay style? How's it work?
Yeah, we've done a bit of both, Ed.
Okay.
So depending on everybody's level of expertise, I mean, I'm just riding a little hybrid bike, so it's in between a mountain bike and a road bike, and so I don't necessarily have to go as fast as the others. And generally speaking, I just team up with those in my group that want to sort of ride at the same speed that I'm riding. Not a relay, so you just pick your route and your distance, and everybody sort of rides that at their comfort.
Well, you know what? It's a wonderful event. It's less than a month away, and I'm really excited about it. I'm looking forward to meeting you out there, Stewart. It should be fun.
It will be really fun, Ted, and thanks very much for everything that you're doing. Good luck with your training and your bike riding, and I look forward to do the same and meet you up in July.
Wonderful. Thanks so much for talking to me today, Stewart.